EHAs and BHAs. This is a two-part series, and if you haven't seen part one, please take a moment and look at that one too. So BHAs and EHAs can be found in a variety of cleansers, toners, moisturizers, serums, peels, scrubs, and masks. So you have to be very careful not to overtax or overexfoliate your skin. So EHAs are primarily used for hyperpigmentation, like spots, melasma, scars, enlarged pores, fine lines, surface dehydration, uneven pigmentation and tone. Although EHAs are often marked as safe for all skin types, you'll need to be extremely careful if you have dry skin and sensitive, if you have rosacea. I always advise to do a patch test because we do not want to get a reaction or damage the skin barrier. So very quickly, if this is your first time on my channel, my name is Maria and welcome to my channel. I am an aesthetics instructor and examiner for many, many years. I ongoing create online aesthetics programs for people who want to become aestheticians. So give me comments below. Love to connect with you, answer all the questions that you may have. If you have not subscribed yet, please consider it. Click on the notification bell so you will not miss any of my tutorials. So let's get started. Among EHAs, we have the well-known glycolic acid, which is the smallest of all the EHAs. It penetrates the deepest and is derived from sugarcane. And the most widely used type of acid in the skincare products. EHAs have a number of benefits. For one, they target all areas of the skin. EHA exerts benefits both in the outer layer, the epidermis, and the deeper layers, which is the dermis. So let me talk a little bit more about the difference. In the epidermis, which is the outer layer, this is the one you touch, EHAs have an exfoliative effect, increasing the shedding or of the dead cells retained at the surface. They do this by gently cleaving to the retained bonds between the dead cells. Once that's cut loose, those cells, they either fall off or exfoliate. Deeper in the dermis, it stimulates the collagen production, making ideal to those wanting to reduce the appearance of fine lines. EHA do this both by increasing collagen synthesis by stimulating the fibroblast cells, which is the collagen-producing cells in the skin, and by decreasing, this is so amazing, the degradation in the existing dermal matrix. EHA have been proven effective in reducing the visible signs of sun damage and wrinkles. The dermis is made up of fibers, collagen and elastin, has a lot of different cells, and then it has this viscosity or gel-like substance called the matrix. As we get older, this matrix starts to harden, and so the EHAs greatly helps that, but also you have to look at your, not only the acids, but also the skincare that you're using, your diet and drinking of water. So we have different concentration of products. Usually in cream format, we have the 3 to 5%. Now for me, those percentages don't work that well. It's very, very slow for you to see results. It gives you like moisture to the skin. So really to see good results, you have to have at least 10% for the face, 15% for the body. Now, if you're going up higher, let's say the 20, the 30%, now you have to be a little bit careful. The Ordinary has a 30%. So you have to be a little bit careful and do a little bit of a patch test. Now, 30 and 40% is also done by estheticians. I would not advise you to do the 40% at home. Higher percentages, like a 50 and above, up to 70%, is usually done by doctors, dermatologists. For home use, select concentration again, 10% for the face and 15% for the body. Apply the product every second day, I would say, and until the body gets used to it. But keep a close eye with any side effects such as irritation. Now, no matter which HA you're going to choose, your skin will be more sensitive to the sun. So I totally advise to wear a hat, stay out of the sun, use a mineral sunscreen every morning to prevent sunburns, age spots, and increase skin cancer risks. So now let's look at different types of HAs. The first one that I mentioned is glycolic acid. It helps with exfoliation. The molecules are much smaller. It penetrates deeper. It has an antimicrobial effect. So it does help with acne breakouts, and it comes from sugarcane. Lactic acid is another common HA. Now, unlike the other ones, it does not come from fruit. It comes from lactose in milk. It's also known for its significant exfoliation and anti-aging effect. The next one is tartaric acid. While it's not widely known, it's another type of HA. It's made up from grape extract, and it may help alleviate signs of sun damage and acne. And usually tartaric is combined with other HAs. Citric acid is made up from citrus fruit extract. Its main purpose is to neutralize the skin pH level, and it also helps with rough patches. Usually you find them in toners and moisturizers, sometimes also in concentrated serum. Malic acid is a type of HA-BHA crossover. It's made from apples or apple acids. Compared to other HAs, malic acid isn't as effective as a solo ingredient, so it's usually combined with other HAs. The mandelic acid contains larger molecules, so it doesn't penetrate that deep. It's derived from almond extract, and it can be combined with other HAs to increase exfoliation. So usually it's not found alone, it's always combined with other HAs. It's used to help with texture and pore size. Now, HAs, they do come with some side effects. And most often these side effects occur in skin peeling products. So that's why I do believe in patch tests. Side effects are usually local, means that they happen where you apply the product. So if you apply it here, you're not going to have a side effect on your thigh. Now, they may include such as burning sensation on the skin, rash, swelling, changes in skin color, sometimes blistering or welts, skin peeling, itching, irritation, chemical burns, and absolutely sensitivity to the sun. So please be very careful when you use any kind of acids. The BHA stand for beta hydroxy acid, and the most popular is the salicylic acid. The BHAs are organic carboxylic acids that work on the skin surface and deep inside the pores, often preferred for normal to oily skin that's prone to bumps, clogs, blemishes, and enlarged pores. BHAs has a skin calming properties. It gets a bonus points for being gentle enough for sensitive skin, including those prone to redness like Couperose and Rosacea. Salicylic acid is the most common in BHAs, usually a concentration between 0.5 and 5%, depending on the product that you're using. It's well known as an acne treatment, but can also help calm down sensitive skin, reduce rosacea-related redness and inflammation. So it's an amazing product. For an issue like dry or dehydrated, even normal, HA is your best bet. An HA-BHA combination might work dependently on your skin type, but when your goal is to exfoliate the top layer of your skin, you should be using an HA. when you go to an esthetician or dermatologist, they're using, as I mentioned before, a higher concentration that sometimes you will need to have a downtime. While the over-the-counter cream containing these ingredients will give you a limited effect that takes time to accomplish the desired results. So it is good to work together with an esthetician. You go have a treatment and then you can continue at home with your product. So you're working together with a professional. Now, BHAs don't make your skin as sensitive to the sun compared to the AHAs. However, I would still wear a natural mineral sunscreen every day. This will help prevent further sun damage. Different types of BHAs, okay, well, we know salicylic acid, the beta-hydroxybutyric acid, that's a full mouthful, tropic acid, and the triclocanic acid. Now, some of the questions that I got from individual watching my first part one, and these questions are really good. So one of the questions that I got here is, can you use AHAs and BHAs together? Well, they did not see this second part, so that's why they were asking that question. And is indeed safe to use AHAs and BHAs together? I will have a link of The Ordinary below, which is a pretty good product and not that expensive. They target different actions, as discussed before, so they have different benefits. In essence, the BHA disrupts the connections between the dead cells, while the AHA causes the dead cells to detach and slough off away. Another question that I have is, which should I apply first, AHAs or BHAs? Well, in my opinion, you should use the BHA first, then your AHA. That way, the BHA can go deeper into the skin, unblock all whatever the blackheads or the dirt in the pores, and as well will prepare the skin for the AHAs. Now, some products, they will be combined together, AHA, BHA together, okay, or in the product itself. Now, after using your acid, depending on the percentage, so if you're using the 3 or 5, even up to the 15, you do not need to rinse it off. However, if you have a 20 or 30%, you leave it on depending on the protocol of that product. It could be 5 or 10 minutes. Rinse it off. Now, some products you will need to neutralize that product. It will vary. Please follow the protocol. Once you remove it, then you continue with your skincare regime. Another question that I got was, can I combine the AHAs with the hyaluronic acid? Yes, you can. In fact, this is an ideal combination. Hyaluronic acid doesn't function like an AHA, BHA, even though you have that acid in the name. It does not strip the skin. Actually, it nourishes and hydrates the skin. So that combination is really good. You just have to give some time. So if you are using your HA, BHA, give it a little bit of time and then you apply your hyaluronic acid. Okay, another question that I have here, can I mix HAs with niacinamide? Yes, certainly you can. To make niacinamide and AHAs work together, layer them on a cleansed face. Just wait some time apart. So again, once you do your HA, BHA, wait a little while, and then you can apply your niacinamide. In my opinion, I would use the niacinamide in the morning and always your exfoliators like AHAs and BHAs at night. Okay, another question that I have here. Can I use AHAs and BHAs together with retinol? If you're following me, you know that I do not like retin-A's and retinols because I find it too evasive. They cause irritation. But There's no research anywhere demonstrating that or concludes that AHAs or BHA exfoliants deactivates or make retinols less effective when used in the same skincare routine. However, in my opinion, is that they're all exfoliators. So make a decision. Do you want to use the AHAs, BHAs? Great. Or use retinols. Don't use them all at the same time because it could cause damage to your skin barrier or your acid mantle. So be very careful not to overstimulate, damaging your beautiful skin. I hope that you found this video and part one to be useful and walk away with simple and easy tips on how to use these exfoliators correctly. Remember not to overexfoliate or overtaxing your skin, damaging your skin barrier or your acid mantle, and consult with an esthetician or professional for more information. Give me comments below, give me questions, because I love to connect with you. Until the next time, take care.